Oh, baby, I love you so much. I want you. I want you badly. Oh, my God. Welcome back to Channel Cardi Global. Hi, I'm Editor James. Oh, today I brought you a beast from Hyundai. What I have today is a Hyundai IONIQ5 N. As always, I'm gonna go over the front first. All right, here what you see is the N badge. N badge, what is it? High performance. Don't F with me, I am a high performance mother. You know what I mean? This is a Hyundai's electric vehicle, and it also, it is a very, very high performance car. It is so fun, you can count on it. My heart is still pounding because I was having just too much fun. You can literally chew out Porsche Taycan. Believe me, this car is super fun. Anyway, as I already made a review during the launching show, it's the same vehicle. So I'm not gonna go over too much. So basically, I'm gonna explain what it has. So again, here in the front, you see the N badge as well as the lights on each side. And then the difference between the N model and the regular IONIQ model is that you have you have orange stripe right in the middle. And then the grill, I think there was a little bit different. But then because this is a high performance vehicle, it has all these end parts in the front. So let me try to put the picture, the difference, how it looks different from the normal model and the end model. So again, it has end parts in the front. Blue license tag means it's an environmentally friendly vehicle in South Korea. So usually we have a white license plate, but then because this is an electric vehicle, we have blue license tag. Again, we have all these lips, looks gorgeous, isn't it? And we have orange stripe going from all the way right to the left. And all these high glossy lips and bumper looks really, really gorgeous. Here, right in the center, we have the camera, which will be assisting you when you are parking, even when you are driving. So again, this is another feature that nowadays cars have. Look at the hood. Look at the Hyundai emblem. Well, normally it's a silver, but we have a matte black emblem. Again, this tells you, hey, I am different. All right. What you're looking at is Atlas white. This is matte color. This is not really glossy. It looks like it has some wrapping done on the car, but I think this was how originally it was made. So again, even when you're washing your car, you don't have to like wax it or anything. I think it's gonna be so much easier. But then again, that's not the biggest concern. The biggest concern is what this baby can do. Oh my God. I'm gonna have to put so much review during the driving because there are so many functions, so many features that drivers can do. And because it is pushing about more than 600 horsepower, you can have so much fun. Believe me, Taycan and Hyundai is the. All right, again, on the side, we have a huge 21-inch rims with the Pirelli Zero tires. So because this is a testing vehicle and we don't have too many tread wear left, but then look, we have N caliper, huge disc, and beautiful and gorgeous looking designed rims. I think the color silver and matte black and the N logo right in the center, it looks so attractive. All right, The side mirror is a high glossy. We have some lightning right here, which you will see when you are blinking or when you are putting on an emergency light. And again, we have orange stripe going all the way from to all the way back. And if you look at it, we have some air holes, which will be helping tires to cool off a little bit, especially when you are driving at high speed or when you are driving this car on a track. So a little consideration, this little holes, it looks like this is nothing, but yes, it makes a huge difference. Again, this is an electric vehicle, so you don't really have a door knob, right? You don't really have a door knob, but when this is unlocked, this little lever, this knob just kind of pops out. And then when you unlock the door, it automatically goes back in. A pillar, B pillar, C pillar, we have a high glossy black, but then everything else is Atlas white. Well, I personally don't like a white cars because it easily gets dirty, but then since this is a matte white, I think it looks really okay. All right, nowadays Hyundai's have putting a lot of lines on the side too. So personally, I don't like to have all these lines. Why? Because even if when you get into small minor accident, let's just say someone hit you on the side, it's really, really difficult to bring it back to original condition or to bring it back to how it originally was. Hyundai has been putting a lot of lines on IONIQ 5, Avante, you know. BMW has M Performance. Mr. Chung made N. Oh, I'm loving it. Now the rear, we have the spoiler on the top, and then right below the spoiler we have another camera. This is not parking assisting camera, this is the camera for the digital mirror, which I have already explained on other reviews. All right, so again, yes, digital mirrors, I told you, right, it's really handy during the nighttime. It allows to see what the people in the back are doing. I'm talking about the people who are behind you, behind your car. So yeah, on my other review, like I asked them, don't pick your nose because I can see you, right? Another biggest difference that IONIQ 5N has from the normal model is that we have the rear window wiper. The normal model, the regular model, didn't have the wiper, but then N model has adopted rear window wiper. Because I guess some people made a complaint, so Hyundai is thinking about adopting the rear mirror wiper in the near future, but that's just a rumor, that's just a word on the street. So yeah, we're not perfectly sure. Again, IONIQ 5, it's black, right? Again, white color with a black lettering, just like we have seen in the front, big N emblem, black emblem, right? It just kind of tells you, hey, I am different from the normal model, okay? Here in the center, we have orange stripe. And again, IONIQ 5, the lettering is all colored black, which tells you, hey, I am different from the normal model. And the rear lamps, all pixel types, even more iconic at nighttime, so it's pretty cool. I'm starting loving this N badge. I thought M Performance, M badge was crazy, but if you drive this car, you will see why N badge is so valuable. Again, blue license tag, it means EV, environmentally friendly, and this is an electric vehicle. Again, here we have another camera. This is what will help you. This camera is the one that's gonna help you when you are parking, when you're backing, okay? And another difference from the normal model is that we have the diffuser, which normal model didn't have. So again, this is like kind of like N part stuff, okay? We have a lot of orange lines, which we didn't see in the normal models, but then I guess it is because to make a difference from the normal model to high performance models. All right, let me quickly go over the interior. Again, there's no change. It's the same model that I made a review during the launching show. All right, this is my driving position, and I want you to take a look at how much leg space I have. I'm comfortable. I'm really comfortable. So even when you have a family of four, this is going to be very ideal. It's going to be more than enough to have four people in the car. Especially, this is an N high performance car, right? So it is not only big, but you can also have fun. All right. Right in the center, we have two Type-C charging ports, okay? And on the side, we have air vents. And we have on the window, we have a sunscreen. So yeah, which you will have to do it manually, but still you have a sunscreen, okay? The most important thing I wanna bring out is how much space this car is providing in the back. So even a big people like me, okay, sitting in the back shouldn't be a problem at all. So I'm just want to tell you that I'm really, really comfortable, and then I have a lot of space. So it's not going to be any problem even when you are going a long distance. All right. Right in the center, we have two Type-C charging ports. Okay. So again, you can charge your smartphones, smart devices, whatever you need to. And on the B pillar on the side, you have air vents, so which will be comforting you during your ride. On the window, we have a sunshade, which you will have to use it manually, but still, it's always better to have something than nothing, you know. So again, just wanted to show you that. And if you wanna recline, adjust your sitting position, okay? Because this is an electric vehicle, this is not automatic. If you slide your hands down on the side of the seat, right, there is a lever. So again, if you pull it up, it reclines towards the front. But if you push the seat with your back like that, and then you can adjust the sitting position that you like. And then once you set it, you can just let go of your hand, that this is how it is going to be. So in the center, we have the letter in here. I think this is all Alcantara, you know? So yeah, Alcantara is sometimes very hard to clean, but then, you know, not too many people sitting in the back anyway. So just wanted to tell you how big, how spacious the rear is. All right, well, I'm sitting in the driver's seat. So what is the biggest change from the normal IONIQ 5 model? It's the center. I don't know what you call it here.
So it's the center console. All right. This
used to, okay? The on normal model, it used to. I mean, I'm not used to. It moves back and forth. But this is N model, high performance. When you are driving, when you are pushing it to the edge, your body will move when you turn, when you're cornering, whatever. So you need some kind of a supports, okay? You are driving, you are pushing this car to the edge, and if your body is keep on moving back and forth, left to right, sometimes it's really hard to control. But then, now, this center console right here, because it is now fixed right in where it is, you can lean on it, and then it help you stay still in position. So that is the biggest change that it has made between the N model and the normal model. Everything else is pretty much the same. Nowadays, Hyundai cars, Kia cars, they adopt all this curved display, but this is one simple, straight, flat screens, two clusters, the gauge and the infotainment. Right below the infotainment, we have a climate control and all these buttons. So to be honest, all this, like, you know, interior, it doesn't look really fancy, but hey, I'm still happy with what it can do when it comes to performance, okay? Steering wheel, oh my God, there are so many buttons. Drive mode, two N buttons, NGB, and we have a big fat and logo. I'm starting to loving this logo. Mr. Chung, call me. Yeah, so steering wheel, yes, again, this is an Alcantara, NGB, N green boost. You know, I explained about this button. Once you press this button, you are juicing out everything for 20 seconds. And what this baby can do, okay? What's surprising is these N buttons right here. which I will show you in a minute. Okay? Again, IONIQ 5N also adopted a digital rear mirror. So right now, this is just simple glass, simple mirror, right? But if you pull this lever, it changes to digital mirror. This is going to be really handy during the nighttime. We have
wireless
phone charger. And then this picture I showed you, right? When the light is turned on the top, you are only charging. But then if you press the button one more time, and then here you are charging at the same time you are connecting your phone to the navigation or to the infotainment. So you can use whatever you have in your phone and bring it up to the screen, listen to music, watch a movie, whatever you like it. So again, you can charge and you can charge and use what you have in your phone to your car. So this is another cool things that Hyundai has adopted. We have another Type-C port as well as 12-volt speaker jack. Okay, so nowadays, again, I have mentioned before, Hyundai cars, Kia cars, Genesis, we provide, not we, Mr. Chung and his team, they provide so many charging ports, so charging your smart devices, your phone, shouldn't be a problem at all. Unfortunately, this is a testing vehicle, and then we received the one without the sunroof. It would have been better to show what it looks like with the sunroof, but unfortunately, we didn't get the one with the sunroof, so please understand. The last thing I want to go over is the bucket seat, okay? I'm very used to sitting on the bucket seat because I have an old one Honda Prelude, and then I also have a bucket seat, okay? I switched it, but then, yeah, this is all Alcantara in the middle, and then on the side is the all leather. So again, we have a big fat N logo, and it's not uncomfortable at all. I mean, I'm very used to sitting on the bucket seat, so yeah, it feels a little bit low, but then you will get used to it. At least it will hold you in position when you are speeding, when you are turning. Believe me, bucket seat does what it does the best. But unfortunately, it doesn't have the heated, you know, seating function, but then it has a cooling fan. So even in the summertime when you're driving, even though this is a bucket seat, your back will not be covered in sweat. You will have cooling fan under the seat. So even when you are driving, you will feel very cool.